Welcome inside to Davis High School for tonight's matchup between the Clearfield Falcons and Davis Darts. My name is JT Wisterzil. Excited to be with you on the call. Just two games remain in the high school basketball regular season before the playoffs get underway next week. Have a fun matchup on hand for you here. Falcons come into this one 6-13, while the Darts 12-9. Starting lineups for both sides. First for the Darts, it's Coleman Atwater. Also starting is Bennett Wright, Alex Fisher, Zach Fisher, and Kate Neggett. As for the Clearfield Falcons, it'll be Peyton Cotter, Trace Hansen, Austin Mitchell, Lincoln Church, and James Barraza. Up top, Hansen tries to feed it inside, but it's tipped out. Last touch by the Darts. Second meeting between these two teams. That first one was an absolute thriller. 58-50, Davis won. Davis got out to a 13-8 lead, but over the course of the next two quarters, nice comeback by Clearfield, particularly in the third, where they outscored the Darts 14-7. Then in the fourth, 24-18, Darts outscored the Falcons to get the win. Turnover. Back-to-back turnovers. As soon as the Darts get it, they'll turn it right back over after it was lost off the foot. Hansen swings it over to Cotter. Cotter back to Hansen. Cotter has it up top, jabs, drives, nearly loses it, gets it back, looks, turns, feeds Mitchell up top. Mitchell puts it on the deck. Back to Barraza. Outside triple. Won't go. Davis has it. Wright brings it up. Zach Fisher swings it over to Wright. Wright looks. Atwater in the corner. Atwater dumps it inside to Eggett. Eggett kicks it back out. Alex Fisher back out to Eggett. Eggett thinks about it, takes, and drains the top of the key three. Davis strikes first. This is a Darts team that is very strong in first quarters. They've done a good job building leads on the season. That shot off the mark. Falcons have struggled recently. They're 0 for their last five games since playing Davis. Davis is 2-3. They had a three-game losing streak after that game to Clearfield. But since 2-0, things appear to be coming together as the Darts turn it over. Hansen running the floor. Blocked, but a foul. Zach Fisher going to be called for the personal. I'll send Trace Hansen to the line. Hansen, averaging 7.8 points per game. Just over an assist and the rebound. Hansen at 11 points, 4 rebounds, 5 assists, and 2 blocks in the last matchup between the Falcons and Darts. One thing you got to imagine Clearfield wants to do is limit the turnovers. Last time they played Davis, they turned it over 11 times overall. Excuse me, Davis had 11 steals. But Clearfield really struggling with turnovers in that first bout. Up top with it. Just swinging into Fisher. Fisher drives. Has it stuck down low. Tries to kick it out to Wright. Atwater from the outside. Can't get it to fall. Battled around down low. Eggett collects and finishes. What a start for Caden Eggett. He's got an early five for the Darts. First personal foul says to James Barraza. Eggett looking to complete the three-point play. He'll do just that. Falcons setting it up. Swinging off over to Barraza. Barraza with the jump hook, too strong. But coming in to collect the offensive rebound is Austin Mitchell, and he'll finish it. The 6'10 forward averages 12 a game and 2.6 rebounds. Trim the lead to 2. Davis looking around. Swing it over. Fisher on the drive. Hangs. Tries to flip. Can't finish. No whistle. Coach Sims wanted a call. He won't get one. Hansen drives. Kicks. Church. Back to Hansen. Hansen. Over to Mitchell. Wide open. Cotter. puts it on the deck, nearly loses it, ends up in the hands of Barraza. Barraza gets it to drop. Six six with 4:50 to go in our first quarter inside Davis High. Atwater up top. Atwater been the sixth man for a lot of the deals. Nearly an incredible turnover. Well, what a steal, I should say, by Lincoln Church, as Church sold out for that one. Unfortunately, his momentum carried him out of bounds, but a great job jumping that pass. Nearly hung on for the turnover, too. Eggett. Over to Wright. Wright to Eggett. Eggett back to Wright. Wright drives. Tries to swing a pass. Easily taken away. Good job by the Falcons defense early. They'll swing it over to Cotter. Cotter, no hesitation. Too strong. Fisher tries to tip it ahead to himself, but Cotter able to get it back. Church swings to Barraza. Cotter thought about the three instead. Works it over to Mitchell. On the left wing, Hansen. Off the mark, but to collect the offensive rebounds, Barraza. He's been active early. Tries to swing it inside to Mitchell. Davis deflects it. Doing a good job jumping the passing lane. And Atwater too high. Both teams just a little out of sorts here early. Was senior night for Davis. We saw Coach Sims and the Davis staff. All the darts players honored pregame as the Falcons will be able to. Falcons had to have their senior night last week. They're at Farmington this Friday night. Church with it up top. 6-6, 3:40 to go. Hansen had it. Inside. Shot won't go. Right on the move. Atwater. Thought about the three. Instead puts it on the deck. Nearly traveled with it. Fisher in the corner. You bet! Alex Fisher drains it. Falcons will burn a timeout. 9-6 with 3:25 to go. You're watching KSL Sports Rewind. Or excuse me, looks like it was stopped for something else. Looked like the signal was a timeout there, but apparently it was not. So we'll stay with the air. Apologies for that stoppage. 9-16, 3:13 to go. That one's tipped away. Can't be saved. As we see, a cheerleader gets taken out, unfortunately. Falcons the other way, and they'll score it. Hansen goes through the lane and puts it in. Wright with it. Wright looking for Eggett, gives it to him inside. Eggett tries to use his size. Too far of a pass, Atwater collects it. A little delayed on the over-the-back call for a moment, but eventually the right call made. 9-8, the difference in this one. Brox Turley on for the Falcons. Or excuse me, on for the darts, as is Josh McKnight. Hansen has it up top. They want to get it into Mitchell, but the darts are there with help from behind and doing a good job fronting. Falcons feed Mitchell on the high post. He looks over, down to Barraza. Davis able to take it away. Turley tries to swing it over to Atwater. Atwater back out to Alex Fisher. Oh, excuse me. That was Zach. The triple, Turley off the mark. But Alex Fisher collects the rebound. And Fisher has his pocket pick, but the ball ends up out of bounds. Nice hands from Lincoln Church. 9-8 with 2 minutes to play in our first quarter. Spencer Jones back on the floor. Jones gave the Falcons great minutes in the last matchup between the two teams. We'll see if he can do so again today. Atwater gets it into McKnight. He gets it back. Atwater thought about it. Kicks it. Corner triple. McKnight. Too strong. Davis there. Offensive foul. The call. As I say, Atwater tried to clear out on Church. Davis had 13 the first quarter, the last time they played Clearfield. While Clearfield only scored 8, so they've already matched that mark here with an opportunity to raise it now. Hand off to Church. Back to Jones. Jones jabs, looks, beats Mitchell. Mitchell doubled inside to kick it out. Church, wide open. And gets the friendly bounce in. Big time hit from Church gives Clearfield the early lead. Atwater wastes no time. Or excuse me, Turley tries to fire the quickle. That won't go. So 11-9 the difference. Church has it up top. Rises up and buries the elbow jumper. How about Church heating up, hitting the mark inside Davis High. 13-9. The advantage for Clearfield. Just over a minute to play. Atwater hangs and finishes. Both offenses really starting to heat up. Still a two-point game. 50 seconds left. Shot clock, game clock difference. About 30 seconds. Good turnover away that time from Fisher. Alex Fisher hangs and lays it in. Tie game at 13. Dave is able to turn defense into offense. Falcons have it. Shot clock and game clock difference. About 10 seconds. 35 seconds to go. Cotter leaves it short. Davis comes up with the rebound, and we'll have a foul. It's a tough board down low by McKnight, and he's rewarded with the whistle. Jackson Ogden checks on. seconds to play. Shot clock turned off. Atwater walks it up the floor. The sophomore guard really earned the trust of Coach Sims over the course of the season. He was instrumental in their last win against Clearfield. He did a great job putting the ball on the deck, getting to the free throw line to help them really ice that win. Atwater dribbles it out. Defended by Mitchell. He's got a step on him. He'll kick it. Alex Fisher in the corner. Fisher can't get it to fall. It'll be good if it goes. And just front rimming it was Mitchell. So that'll end a fast-flying first quarter here on KSL Sports Rewind. 13-13, we step away. We'll be back for more Davis basketball action on KSL Sports Rewind. We got a tie ball game inside Davis High School early. This is a great matchup between the Darts and Falcons last time, and it's looking like we could be in for another barn burner here early. Davis got out to the early lead, but Clearfield led by as much as four in that early going. Right with it. He'll feed Eggett inside. Eggett looks, kicks it out. Up top, putting it on the deck is McKnight. McKnight feeds it off to Eggett, who finishes in. Davis retakes the lead. Cotter with it up top. Dumps it off inside, trying to hang. Hansen can't finish it. Ball ends up on the deck. Fight for it. Eventually, Davis ends up with it. Wright trying to lead the charge. Wright dribbles it out. McKnight hands it off. McKnight wide open on the wing. Can't make the defense pay. And we'll have an offensive foul assessed to Jonathan Gordon. The senior forward a little too physical inside. 7-11 to go in our first half. At halftime, Davis will be honoring their former head coach, Joey Welk, the 2002 Utah High School State Championship coach. Will be honored at halftime. We'll leave that stream running for you here on KSL Sports Rewind. Hansen powers his way up, and it's an offensive foul. Way too aggressive as McKnight hits the deck. Mentioned the darts led by head coach Chad Sims, Scott McLaughlin, leader of the Falcons. Hansen a little out of control that time around. Right, hands off to Atwater. Looked into Eggett, but nothing there. McKnight with it, back to Atwater. Right, swings to Atwater. Defended by Mitchell. He drives, kicks it out. The triple is pure. Big time hit by Wright. Net got stuck that time, so they called a quick whistle to try to fix that. Church checks in, as does Davis Wohl. Spencer Jones and Cotter come out of the game for the Falcons. It's amazing how quickly the high school basketball season can fly by, but here we are just a week away from the state tournament getting underway. Wohl swings over to Ogden. Ogden looks, kicks it out. Hansen drives, hands off. Ogden open, can't knock down the middie. Darts push it ahead. Wright slows it down. McKnight open in the corner. They'll dribble it out. Davis working it around up top. 18-13, the difference. Atwater thought about it. Atwater drives, hangs. It's pure. Nice shot and move by the sophomore. Falcons take a timeout. The lead for Davis up to 6. 18-13 on KSL Sports Rewind. Back here inside Davis High School, where the Falcons currently trail by 8 at the moment. Last shot by Davis. Forgot to add that to our scoreboard. So 20-13. Score in this one. Hansen brings it up. Falcons trailed by a lot more than this in the last matchup. They mounted a big comeback, so very much in it. But turnovers like that almost won't help. Hansen able to get it back. Hangs, feeds it off, but leaving it short was Church. Or excuse me, Wohl left it short. Back over to Wohl. He'll hand off to Hansen. Hansen tries to take it inside, and he was fouled. So with 5:07 to play, he's shooting free throws. Clearfield team that we mentioned, they nearly were able to knock off Davis last time at their place, but since hasn't been easy sledding. They lost 65-52 to Farmington, 75-66 to Weber, 72-58 to Layton, 56-43 to Syracuse, and 54-45 to Fremont. A lot of those games are hang around, but just can't finish it off for four quarters, and now have a great chance to do so here. Hansen looks to knock this one down after missing the first. He'll do just that. Darts bring it up the floor. Fisher has it up top. Zach Fisher puts it on the deck. Can't make the shot, but it's because there was contact. 20-14 with just under 5 to play now. Chase McNeil now in the game at center for the Falcons. Zach Fisher averaging 13.7 on the season, 6.8 rebounds, a steal and a block, or excuse me, an assist and a steal for this Davis team. This is a Davis team that was state champs in 2021. Enjoyed immense success under Coach Sims the past few years. This year, a little bit different with those 9 losses, but talked to Coach Sims before the game. He feels like they're starting to hit their stride at the right time. Fisher can't knock down either a free throw, so 20-14, our score remains. Mentioned some of those struggles for Davis. We're 2-3 in the last 5 games, but those last 2 wins have come in their last 2 games, so getting hot at the right time. Falcons nearly turn over. In fact, they will. Darts defensive intensity picking up. Five on the floor for Davis. It's going to be Alex Fisher, who's just checked in. So Alex Fisher, Zach Fisher, the cousins, in for the darts. As well as Coleman Atwater, Caden Agate, and Bennett Wright. Wright looks. Swings it over to Fisher. Nice takeaway that time from Hansen, flying through the lane. Trace Hansen swings it, open triple. Church! Won't go. Zach Fisher gets it. Fisher runs the floor, feeds it to Agate. Exit, can't finish. What a block by Trace Hansen. Agate nearly took it away, but he put his body in the way. That's a personal foul. Just over four to play now. 5 fouls against the Darts, 3 on the Falcons. Pretty clean overall. That was fantastic defense from Hanson on back-to-back possessions. The previous one makes up a ton of ground to soar through for the steal, and then that one able to show to the left side and then recover quickly to the right to block that shot from Eggett. Church swings it to Hanson. Hanson back to Church. They want to look inside to McNeil. Darts taking that away. McNeil gets it. He's got the size, and he scores it. Turning the shoulders to create the separation and finishing it off is Mitchell, or excuse me, Chase McNeil. And Darts sloppy with the ball. They'll turn it over 20-16. Falcons running the floor, and we'll have a foul before the shot. So 20-16, the difference in this one, with 3:24 to play. Hanson has it under the hoop. He'll feed it into McNeil. McNeil, what a block! The emphatic rejection by Zach Fisher. They'll feed Fisher ahead. Fisher nearly lost it, able to keep it. Fisher trying to get rid of it. Atwater resets the Darts offense. Agate creates the separation inside. Kick it out. Zach Fisher, tough looking three. McNeil ends up with the rebound. Hansel will slow it down again. Just under three to play. 20-16. Darts with a narrow advantage. On the jab and drive is Barraza. Atwater pokes it away. Hanson hanging with him. Atwater floats, can't finish. But, oh, Zach Fisher can't finish it either. Falcons try to throw it ahead. Getting it up top is Barraza. He'll dribble it out. Feed Hanson. Hanson kicks it out. Hanson wide open. He drives. Falcons swing it back to Barraza. A lot of good shots they've passed up so far. Church forces one in on the drive. Won't go. Ball poked around. Darts end up with it. Coach Sims wants to settle his team down. 2:16 to play. You're watching KSL Sports Rewind. Welcome back inside to Davis High High School. Senior night for the Darts. Always a great occasion celebrating these hardworking high school athletes, student athletes, their dedication and commitment to the game of basketball. 20-16 with 2:16 to play. Darts feed it in. It's Wright walking it up. Right on the season. Averages just 1.7 points per game. Zach Fisher working inside. Turns, spins. Off the mark. Falcons take it. Under two to play now. Hanson. Defended by Fisher. Swings it back to Mitchell. Just come back in. Into Barraza. Defeats Hanson. Hanson stepped out of bounds. It was going to be a nice pass, but won't go. Caleb Taylor, the junior forward, checking in for this Davis team. This is a young Darts team. We've already seen Atwater get a ton of run. Wright, just a sophomore. Zach Fisher, a junior. Got some prominent seniors still when you're looking at Cade Neggett, Alex Fitcher, and Colby Wicker, but it's a Davis team that will be just fine for next year, too. Atwater drives, whips the cross-court pass to Wright. Over to Fisher. Fisher stuck down low by the quick double, and he traveled, dragging the foot. 1:17 to play. Scoring really dried up as of late. Clearfield with just 3 points in the second quarter. As for Davis, they have 7. Church swings wide open. Barraza, he jabs, mid-ranger, off the mark. Wright runs the floor, Wright whips it over. Alex Fisher off the mark. So Zach Fisher can't knock it down. 45 seconds to play. Shot clock and game clock difference, about 12 seconds. Hansen, too quick. No shot on the foul. They'll call it on the floor. 6'1 guard showing the quickness. NBA, that's easily continuation, but not in high school basketball. 1-1 shooting, so Hansen will still get free throws out of it. Foul count, 7 for the Darts, just 3 for the Falcons. Imagine that's something Coach Sims wants to see cleaned up. First free throw is money. Makes it a one possession game. Hansen looking to cut it to just a 2-point game. Won't be able to. Falcons will have to settle for just one make. Davis gets it. Shot clock and game clock difference. About 5 seconds. Wright gets a screen from Eggett. Feeds Eggett. Eggett kicks it out to Atwater. Atwater drives, hangs, and makes it. Tough move by the sophomore. Shot clock turned off. 16 seconds to go. Hansen wants the screen from Mitchell, but he's telling him to wait. Falcons got to go with it down to 7. Hansen drives, steps back. What a hit! Trace Hansen trying to steal the show on senior night with that tough bucket. 22-19, we head into the half. What a hard-fought first quarter it was. We'll be back in 10 minutes on KSL Sports Rewind for the second half. Hello, everyone, and welcome back inside to Davis High School. Darts were able to hold on to a narrow 22-19 lead as time ran out in our first half. Should be a great second half on hand for you. Davis and Clearfield tied at 13 at the end of the first quarter. Then a low-scoring second quarter. Clearfield with just 6 points, 3 points for the majority of that quarter. They didn't score those other three until the final minute. Then you also got 9 points from the Darts in that one. It's a very even game. Really, the big difference to point to is just made threes. Davis with 3 to just 1 for Clearfield. Neither team shooting it well from the outside, though. For Davis, they're just at 27%, while Clearfield is at 16%. Leading scorers, first for the Clearfield Falcons, 8 for Trace Hansen, 5 for Lincoln Church. As for the Darts, it's 8 for Cade Neggett, 6 for Coleman Atwater, and 5 for Alex Fisher. This one a lot closer than it was at the half last time between the Darts and the Falcons. And we know how drastically that one turned in the third quarter. Clearfield scored 14 in the third to just 7 for the Falcons. We'll see what this one yields. Church drains it from distance, ties the game in an instant. Cross-court pass over to Atwater. Atwater, he's off the mark. Hansen collects the rebound. Hansen resets the offense, settles it down. Hansen kicks wide open. Cotter in the corner. Can't get it to fall, but Mitchell just too tall. He collects and finishes. Clearfield regains the lead. They got 5 in the second half. A reminder, they only had 6 in the second quarter. Atwater drives, looks, over to Eggett. Eggett swings it back. Atwater receives it. Eggett drives, doubled, kicks it out to Atwater. Up top right, puts it on the deck. Eggett wide open in the corner. Can't connect on it. But the offensive rebound collected and finished by Alex Fisher. All tied up at 24. Back and forth we go. This one seems like one that'll come down to the wire. Happy Valentine's Day to everyone tuning in. Cotter on the right wing. Looks. Swings it up top. Inside, it's Mitchell. Just too tall. The 6'10 forward giving the Darts problems. ...26-24, the Falcons lead. Quick take and make from Fisher. Jabs and puts it on the decks. Alex Fisher scores. Darts decide to take a timeout. We are all tied up at 26 inside Davis High School on KSL Sports Rewind. 26 all. It's our second half. Just a few minutes into it. Just basically 2 minutes played. Offense has been off the charts in this one. If you look at it, we have 7 points scored already by the Falcons, which is more than they had in the first half. In the second quarter. Then you have 4 points scored by the Darts as the Falcons walk it up slowly. Hand it off. Clearfield looking. Cotter looking for a teammate to hop open. Mitchell puts it on the deck. Bounced around. Who's it last touched by? Last touch by Davis. .5:30 to play. 6:10, Mitchell has it. Swing it to Hansen. Hansen, cross-court pass over to Barraza. Barraza has it poked away, but Davis stepped out of bounds. That time it was Caleb Taylor. Hansen under the hoop. Looks, gets it into Mitchell. Mitchell can't score it, but he was fouled. So Austin Mitchell really getting going here. The leading scorer on the season for this Falcons team at 12.7 a game. Mitchell at the line. Buries the first. Mitchell looking to go 2 for 2. How about the big man showing the touch? 28-26, 5:20 to play. Atwater over to Zach Fisher. Fisher puts it on the floor. Offensive foul. Going to go against Zach Fisher. Two team fouls now on Davis in the half. Fisher a little hobbled after that, but appears to be all right. He'll defend Hansen. Falcons trying to get it inside, and they can't get it over to Mitchell. Mitchell trying to seal out water. Pass a little too far from his reach. Under 5 to play. Atwater gets it, jabs, nearly loses it. Help defender comes over, swing in the corner. Zach Fisher waits, hangs, and finishes. Nice move by Zach Fisher. The junior forward ties us all at 28. Falcons stuck, get it up to Mitchell up top. Mitchell. Swings it into Hansen. Hansen back to Mitchell. Mitchell too tall. He scores it. Falcons first to reach 30. Atwater puts it on the deck. Leaves it short. Hansen. Passes it back to Mitchell. Mitchell. His shot won't fall. Atwater's got it. Coach Sims wants him to push the pace. Zach Fisher drives, nearly has it poked away. It will be. Nice hands from Lincoln Church. Foul on the other end. 3:39 to play. Man, just barely over halfway through this third quarter. What a start it's been. Zach Fisher checks out. Eggett checks back in. Coach Scott McLaughlin and his Falcons really trying to get a win here. That winless stretch, they haven't given up, and they fought hard. It's because of plays like that by Peyton Cotter. Cotter takes the contact and finishes. 4 points the lead now. 34-28. Triple off the mark. Tapped around. Eventually the Falcons get it. They swing it over. Hanging for the floater. And can't finish it with Church. Darts push it ahead. Atwater with it. Under three to play now. Aggie gets it on the baseline, nearly turns it over. Feeds it out to Wright. They'll reset the offense. Shot clock under 15, 2:45 to play. Aggie over to Atwater. Now down to five. Atwater drives, looks, turns. Alex Fisher got to go. And Fisher airballs. Shot clock violation forced by the Falcons. Ogden and Jones come in for Clearfield. Jonathan Gordon. As you see, a push called on the other end by Taylor, but Gordon and McKnight coming on. Jones with it now. Backdoor cut, Cotter leaves it off for Mitchell. Mitchell throws it down. What a sequence for the Falcons. The Falcons student section is roaring. They traveled well. 34-28, Atwater silences them just as quickly. Back to a 4-point game. On the other end, Mitchell swings it over to Jones. Church rises and knocks down the two. 6 points the difference, under two to play at a minute 35. Atwater drives, squeezes, can't finish, but foul called. to play. What a great one it's been inside the Davis High School. Atwater knocks in the first. Chase McNeil checks in for Austin Mitchell. Mitchell gets a nice applause. He's been dominant this third quarter. His size has really given the Darts issues. 36-31, Atwater, ice in his veins as always, 2-for-2 at the line. Game back to four. On the other end, they'll feed McNeil inside. McNeil kicks it out to Church. Church drives, hangs, Eggett easily sends it back. Atwater up ahead. Atwater kicks it, open triple. Is pure! Big hit by Caleb Taylor. And just like that, it's a one-point game with a minute to play in our third quarter. Timeout the call by the Falcons. 36-35 with 58 to play on KSL Sports Rewind. Falcons set to feed it in. Cotter with it. Hands off to Jones. Shot clock and game clock difference, 30 seconds. Jones dribbles. They'll try to get into McNeil. McNeil doubled. McNeil tries to put it on the deck. He fades. Tries to use the bank, but can't get it to fall. And the foul called on Potter. Atwater's got it. Gets the screen from Eggett. Atwater drives, floats, swings. Davis working it around. Great recovery by the Falcons, but they forget about Atwater. He can't connect, though. Up top, the triple is left short by Taylor. But Davis gets the offensive rebound. Just 10 on the clock now in our third quarter. Atwater looks, drives in, tries to flip it up. It's blocked. 1 second to play. It's poked away. No one will be able to get it off. So that is the end of a fast and furious third quarter. And we got another one coming up for you on the fourth. 36-35. Falcons lead it by one over the Darts on KSL Sports Rewind. Darts and Falcons faithful roaring alike on KSL Sports Rewind. Now getting into our fourth quarter here. 36-35 with 8 minutes to go. Eggett tosses it in. So it'll be Eggett, Bennett Wright, Coleman Atwater, Caleb Taylor, and Josh McKnight all on the floor for the Darts. As for the Falcons, they'll roll with McNeil, Cotter. Nice move by Eggett. He'll hang and finish. So Hanson, Cotter, McNeil, Jones, and James Braza, the five on the floor for the Falcons. 37-36 now. Jones with it. Falcons turn it over. 37-36. Atwater whips it. Cross-court pass. The triple. Off the mark. Taylor swings it to Atwater. Atwater defended by Jones. Nearly has it poked away. He'll drive. Feed it back over to Taylor in the corner. And Taylor connects on the second try. 40-36, just in the blink of an eye. It's now a Davis 4-point lead. On the other end, it's another Clearfield turnover. We had 18 points scored in the third by the Falcons. But in the fourth, it's all Davis. Coach McLaughlin can do nothing but take a timeout. Eggett with two early buckets in the fourth. Factor in the Taylor triple. And you got a 6-point lead for the Davis Darts. What a start to the fourth quarter by the Davis Darts. They scored 13 points in the third. They now have 7 in just the fourth quarter. This is the Davis team we talked about the last time they played Clearfield. Just 7 third quarter points. And then in the fourth, they exploded for 24 to take the game out of the Falcons' clutches. As for Clearfield, they're coming off a third quarter in which they threw up points aplenty. Overall scoring 17. But now they trail by 6. They turned it over a couple times. That's why we see Mitchell back in the game. Mitchell swings it over to Hanson. Hanson over to Jones. Jones drives back to Hanson. Mitchell has it up top. Mitchell tries to power his way in. Davis defense seemingly everywhere. Hanson buries it. Big time hit for the senior. 42-39. Hanson was quiet in that third, but man, did he just come to life with a nice hit there. Ogden, too tenacious on the defense, commits the personal. Atwater. Gets the screen from Josh McKnight. Atwater defended by Hanson. McKnight thought about the three. Instead swings it over. The jab, the drive. Alex Fisher has it poked away. Running the floor. Braza hands it back to Mitchell. And Mitchell fouled. He's going to the line for two. Yeah. Wright checks in. ...42-39. Mitchell knocks down another. He's been devastating at the free throw line. Zach Fisher back in the game, as is Bennett Wright. ...40-42, 5:36 to go. Mitchell. Too strong, and we're in a two-point game, but the Falcons able to collect the offensive rebound. And Mitchell has it, but can't get it to go with the point-blank rim miss. Atwater swings it. Eggett has it up top. Atwater has it up top. The sophomore has been devastating. He'll swing it over to the junior in Zach Fisher. Atwater with it again. Atwater off the screen. He looks, tries to take it in himself, and a foul called on Hansen. He is furious. Two shots coming up for Atwater. Lincoln Church set to check in. ...42-40, 5:01 to play. Atwater knocks down the first. ...43-40. Another shot buried. Lead back up to four. Atwater always so clutch at the line, as he was the last time the Falcons and Darts faced off. They want to feed Mitchell. Good defense by the Falcons. Nearly has it poked away. Barraza with it. He'll swing it over to Cotter. Cotter. Back up top to Hansen. Hansen over to Mitchell. And it's poked away. Great hands from Wright to deflect the pass. Wright doubled, but able to get out of it. Feeds Atwater. Atwater looks. Misses two open darts, but that's okay. Davis can reset. Under 4:20 to play. Fisher hangs and finishes. Beautiful float and the finish off the fingertips. 6 points now, the Davis lead. Clearfield, so clearly the better team for the majority of the third quarter. Now in danger of letting another upset slip away, but not if Trace Hansen has anything to say about it. He'll drain the three. And it'll be a Clearfield timeout. 3-point game, just under four to play. Don't go anywhere. You're watching KSL Sports Rewind. We have seen a few tough baskets from Trace Hansen during the fourth quarter. What a three he just had. Felt like the game was really getting away from the Falcons. They're able to stay locked in and hit the huge shot. 46-43, 3:59 to play. Falcons looking for their first win in what has been a tough couple games for them. 0-5, 0-6 if you go back to that Davis Clearfield game. Atwater gets it under the hoop. Falcons will lay back. Hansen's hit some big-time shots. Atwater's made some clutch free throws. We'll see what gives in the final. 3:58. Wright gets Mitchell matched up on him. They're trying to get the mismatch inside. Fisher wide open. Fisher drives and hard foul. Nothing malicious about it. Mitchell just going in for the tough block. But Fisher shaking up for a moment before popping up to his feet. So Zach Fisher, the junior forward, goes to the line. His cousin Alex Fisher going to come on in a second. ...46-43. One of our refs and Zach Fisher talking things over. Maybe Fisher felt like that should have been a technical where... Not down there, so he can't hear those combinations. Fisher barely hits rim on the first. Wright takes a seat as Fisher. That being Alex Fisher, Jack Sisson in for him with Zach Fisher at the line. And he will miss ball. Still a one possession game. Falcons still very much in this one. Hansen. Just over 3:30 to play. They want to get in to Mitchell. Dart's defense is there all the way. They double him inside. And it's a turnover. Taylor scoops it up. And Taylor easily lays it up and in. No Ike Morgan or Colby Wicker tonight for the Darts, but they've managed all right without him. They now lead by 5. Swing it over. Falcons get into Braza. Offensive foul. Too physical that time. 48-43 with just under 3 to play. It's been a fantastic game between the Falcons and Darts. Atwater set to take it out. Jones checks in. In for Church. Right back in the game. Darts looking for what would be their 13th win of the season. Clearfield trying to avoid what would be their 14th loss. The feed to Atwater. They'll swing it over. Nearly a turnover. Shot clock down to 20. Just over 2:30 to play. Wright drives, looks. And it's picked off. Great hands by Hansen. Hansen leaves it off for Mitchell. Mitchell finishes it right through Fisher. 3-point game, 48-45. Atwater, fouled by Hansen. That'll be the 7th foul, so that's free throws. Tough foul by Hansen. Third personal foul assessed to Hansen. Atwater. Can't make it. It stays in a 3-point game. Atwater hits so many huge free throws and nearly a turnover by Jones as he's able to get back on top of it. Hansen with it. Just under 2 to play now. Cotter back to Hansen. Mitchell there for the screen. Hansen drives, swings. Cotter. He's got it. Huge hit for Peyton Cotter. And that was stuck, so they reset it. We have a tie game with 1:50 to play. Sub coming on. Alex Fisher back in. We said it early on. This one had the feel of one that would come down to the wire, and it's played out just like that. 1:45 to play. Atwater. Looks, swings it over to Alex Fisher. Fisher looking, back up to Atwater. Atwater drives, spins, swings. Taylor, off the mark. Falcons collect it. 1:20 to play. Falcons and Dart student sections both going wild in a great atmosphere here at Davis High. Jones over to Mitchell. Mitchell looks. The three Cotter, good double by Davis, but he's able to get out of it. Mitchell surveys the floor. Hansen puts it on the deck. Hansen spins, hands it off to Braza. Braza leaves it high up top and drops in the corner. Just under a minute to play. It's a 2-point lead now for the Falcons. Timeout Davis. Clearfield erupting. 52 seconds to play. 2-point lead for the Falcons. It's a full timeout. We'll step away on KSL Sports Rewind. Darts and Falcons duking it out in an absolute thriller. We appreciate all of you for joining us on KSL Sports Rewind. We always have you covered Tuesdays and Fridays with both girls and boys high school action across the state of Utah. And if you have chosen this game, you had made a great decision. 50-48, Falcons looking for the win. The huge shot by Barraza on the floater. Wright's got it now. Wright with it on the right ring. Wright drives, misses Fisher for a moment, then gets it back to Fisher! Count the basket! Big basket by the junior, Zach Fisher. How do you do? Ties it at 50. With a chance at the line now. He missed his last two free throws. We'll try to knock him down here. Josh McKnight and Alex Fisher back in. Zach Fisher wants the lead with 41 seconds left. The Falcons student section doing everything they can to interfere. It won't matter. Big time shot. Coach McLaughlin not going to burn a timeout. Hansen with it. Hansen looks. Thinks about giving it to him. Mitchell, he will. Mitchell looks. Turns. And a timeout by Coach McLaughlin with 16 on the shot clock. 22 seconds remain. So we have about 6 seconds between shot clock and game clock. Don't go anywhere. You're watching KSL Sports Rewind. Seconds to play. Shot clock at 16. Coach of the Falcons, Scott McLaughlin, took a timeout. Didn't like the direction this team was heading in. We'll see what he can get here. Trace Hansen with it. Screen from Jones. Hansen drives. He's stuck, looking for someone. Jones ends up with it. Poked away. Five on the shot clock. Fight for the ball. Passes it ahead. Wide open. Barraza tries to get it up. It won't go. But the tip. Oh, my goodness. Clearfield leads it. And the shot clock just ran out. Pandemonium. What just happened? 51-50 at the moment. They're trying. Coach Simpson's irate that the shot clock ran out. But it looked like it hit the rim, and then Mitchell was there to collect it. The scoreboard has not changed as of this moment. The refs are going to talk it over. Oh, my goodness. We could have just had a buzzer beater. It was absolute chaos. That ball rolled around. I still can't believe. How about Hansen? Has it poked away, gets on top of it, able to throw it ahead to Barraza. Barraza can't get the floater, but the huge follow by Austin Mitchell. The 6'10 forward scores the potential game winner. We got a timeout, Davis. They're going to put time back on the clock. The scoreboard still has not changed. It still says 51-50 darts, but I believe the shot counted. They're talking about it right now. Both fans, students, parents alike, everyone absolutely confused. So they put 3.3 on the clock. It is still 51-50 though. We're still, Clearfield still campaigning to get those points. We're waiting on the confirmation. It should be 52-51, but they have not changed it as they are waiting. Coach Sims having a discussion with the refs. Coach Sims feels like it was a shot clock violation. They just changed it. So it's officially 52-51 right now. So 52-51, 3 seconds to play Coach Sims felt like there was a shot clock violation. He's not going to get it. Falcons with a chance to get the win here. Davis talking things over at the moment. We mentioned Clearfield struggles this season, but that could all change right here. Clearfield student section is really excited. They feel the opportunity. So close to capitalizing on it. Davis got to throw it in. Fisher can run the baseline. Falcons 0-10 in Region 1 play. Fisher gets it to Eggett, and it's picked off by Hansen. Hansen takes it. That's a Clearfield victory. Clearfield wins it in the heart of Davis, stealing the spotlight on senior night. The Falcons have done it. What a performance by Coach McLaughlin's Falcons. Their first win of Region 1 play. They were 0-10 coming into this one, and they knock off a potent Davis team. What a win by the Falcons. The students showed up in support, and they were absolutely rewarded. What a performance by Trace Hansen, hitting big-time shots all over the place. And then late, you get the basket from Mitchell. Mitchell was really instrumental in this victory as well. Dominant inside, changed the entire defense. If playing for the darts, they were doing everything they could to double him, but they didn't box him out when it mattered most. And Mitchell with the putback with 3 seconds. And then Hansen with the steal to eliminate even the slimmest chances of a comeback. Falcons fired up as they high-five. Waiting to see if they'll storm the court here in a moment. What a win for the Falcons as they get their 7th win of the season. And they won't be able to storm the court with the players, but either way, what a win for Clearfield. They'll go to 7-13 on this season. Overall for Davis, they fall to 12-10. We thank all of you for tuning in. Once again, your final, 52-51. The Clearfield Falcons come in and defeat the Davis Darts on senior night. We thank you for watching KSL Sports Rewind. For my cameraman, Bill Francis, I'm JT Wistersill signing off. Have a fantastic Tuesday night.